Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another Shopify how-to video. This is WebSense Pro, where you learn about Shopify, web design and development, and a lot of stuff related to WordPress as well. So in this video, I'll show you guys how you can remove header and footer from your homepage, or if you want to hide it on any specific product page, or if you want to hide it on all of the product page. And if you are creating a landing page for the advertisement purpose, if you're running ad campaign for that landing page and you don't want to display header and footer on that page, you can learn this from this video, where I'll show you guys step by step on how you can do that. All you have to do is just follow the instructions in the video and you'll be able to do that on your own without needing or hiring any developer. So let's learn how we can do that. Okay guys, so as you can see, I have this Shopify development store, where first what we will do is hide header and footer from the entire website, and then I'll show you guys how you can do that only on homepage, and if you want to do that only on a specific product page and on a specific collection page, how you can do that. Okay, and before we move on to that, I want to highlight some of the other tutorials which I have created before. So as you can see, this video is running on a continuous loop. So if you are looking to add a stylish video banner on your store, I have created a tutorial, link in the description. Also, if you can see, I have this transparent header, and when I scroll down, it changes the logo and changes the color. So if you want to learn that as well, link will be in the description. Many other tutorials I have created just for you guys. So if you want to keep watching these videos, please help us by subscribing this channel. Okay, so let's go to the backend and implement hiding header and footer on specific pages. So I'm gonna go to the backend and click on online store. From there, I'm going to click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. In case you are not tech savvy or you don't know how to code, it's better to have a duplicate of your theme if you're working on a live website. Okay, let's click on edit code. And now let's open up the theme.liquid file. I have some files already open, so I'm going to close that. You can search theme.liquid file from here. And from there, under head, I'm going to add a CSS code. So here's the CSS code which I'm going to add. You will find the CSS code in the YouTube video description. There's a link to the blog post. All you have to do is just open that blog and copy this CSS code and paste it here. And then hit save. Now what this CSS will do, it will remove header and footer from the entire website. So if I open up my development store and hit refresh, you can see that I don't have any header showing up, neither the footer. Let's take a look at any of the product page. Yep, you can see I don't have any header footer showing up. Now what we need to do, if we only need to disable header and footer on the homepage, what you can do with that is add an if condition. So that's the if condition for homepage only. If template.name equals to index. So I'm just going to copy this code and wrap my CSS code within that if condition. So again, it's a beginner level tutorial. If you are not tech savvy or code savvy, you can simply copy and paste these codes and implement that on your own without needing for any developer. Okay, now after wrapping my CSS code in the if condition, all I have to do is just save. And now let's check it out. So if I hit refresh, I don't have header footer showing up on my homepage. But if I go now to the product page, you can see that my header and footer is showing up. Right? Now, what if I want to hide only on a specific product page? Like I want to display header and footer on the entire website, but just the one product page where I don't want a header and footer to be displayed. Maybe I'm running a Facebook campaign or something like that. So let's do that. So this is for all of the product pages. So if you want to hide your header for all of the product page, we're gonna check out the specific product page. So I'm just going to copy this if condition and replace my existing if condition with the one which I copied. Now what it's doing, it's testing if product handle equals to this, it will hide the header and footer, right? Now I'm going to delete this and copy my product handle from here. So that's the product handle of my product page. And what it will do, it will remove the header and footer after matching this product handle. So if the product page handle is this, it will remove the header and footer. Now let's test it out. I'm going to copy this handle and paste it within the inverted commas. Let's paste it. So that's my product handle and hit save. Now let's refresh this product page and I don't have any header and footer on this product page. Now let's see if I have it on other pages. Yes, I have it on the home page. Now let's check out the other product. Yes, I do have that on other product page as well. So that we can hide header and footer on a specific product page. And if you want to hide that on all of the product page, all you have to do is just simply add if product condition. So I'm going to remove all of that. And that's it. If product, it's going to check if it's product page, it will remove header and footer. Click save. Hit refresh. And now you can see it's removed from this product. Let's check out some of the products. I'm going to open the other products on new window. And you can see all of the product pages does not have any header and footer. By the way, if you are looking to add color swatches like this without using any Shopify app, I have created a tutorial for that. Link will be in the description. Okay, now let's do that for the collection page. So I have this all products collection page. If I want to remove header and footer from this all products collection page, what I'm going to do is just copy this if condition. So if collection.handle equals to your collection handle, meaning you will replace this your collection handle with the name of collection handle where you want to remove header and footer. Okay, so let's copy this. Go back to code editor. I'm going to close all the extra tabs. Let's paste our if condition here. And in collection handle, I'm going to find my collection handle. So that's the collection handle. I'm going to copy this from here and paste it here. And hit save. Perfect. Now let's go to that collection page and hit refresh. Now you can see that my header and footer has been removed. Cool, right? So guys, assuming you are creating a landing page and you have a custom template on that landing page and you want to hide header and footer on that. Let's do that. Let's first create a new template for a page. So click on these three small dots and open our customizer from customize theme. Now from this dropdown, I'm going to go to pages. And then from here, I'm going to click on create template and name it landing page, or just name it landing, create template. Okay, we have this blank template created. Now what we can do here is simply hide header and footer from here and then click on save. And then you can assign this template to your landing page. Now let's create a new landing page. So let's open up our backend on a new tab. Then click on content. Sorry, click on online store and then pages. Now I'm going to create a new page called landing page. That's my page. And from the theme template, I'm going to select landing. So I have two templates. One is contact and one is landing. I'm going to select the landing because this one does not have a header and a footer. Okay, click on save. And now let's preview this landing page. And as you can see, we do not have any header footer showing up on that landing page. But what if you are using an external editor, like external theme builder, using an app? We have multiple theme builder apps where you can build the theme using a drag and drop builder. If you're using one of those templates, you can do that using Liquid Code. Now let me show you how you can do that. Now let's enable header and footer from our theme customizer. Okay, we have our header and footer back. Click on save. And now if I refresh my landing page, I have the header and footer showing up. Now what if you don't have the customizer option? What you can do is do that from Liquid Code again. So I'm gonna go to my Liquid Code, and in this if condition, what I'm going to do, if template contains landing, so it's basically an if condition. So I did a mistake here, a typo. Okay, fix the typo. Oops. So what it's going to do, it's going to check if the template is the landing, then it will remove the header and footer by adding this CSS code, right? So it will add the CSS code if this condition is true. Perfect. Now hit save. And let's go back to the page and hit refresh. And now you can see we do not have header and footer showing up. Now there is another alternative if you can do that. You can match the page name. So I've added the code here. So that's the code for checking the template, if template contains your template name. And for this condition, you can also match the page title. So if the page title is landing page, then it's going to remove the header and footer. Let's test that out. So I'm just going to remove this page.title equals to landing page. So that's my condition. If this condition is true, then it will add CSS on the head of this theme and it will remove the header and footer, right? Click on save. And then let's test it. You can see we have header and footer not showing up. The reason, because we have this condition which is hitting true. And now let's comment our CSS. If I comment out the CSS and hit save and hit refresh, our header and footer is back again. Add back the CSS, save, go back to the landing page, hit refresh, and we do not have header and footer showing up. So that's it, guys. I have added all of the code instructions in this blog post, which you will find in the YouTube video description. And that's it for the tutorial, guys. If you want to learn more tips and tricks related to Shopify, WordPress, and in general web design and development, let me know in the comments below. Most of the content which we create is requested from you guys, so we would love to hear what more you request. Until next video, have a great day.